Hey, welcome back. Today we're going to be talking about Wrath of the Lich King again. The hype is real. We're going to be talking about how Racials changed. Man, did they change a lot in Wrath of the Lich King. Wrath of the Lich King, such an incredible expansion. It is so fun. And yeah, the Racials changed, and we're going to talk about which class is most suited for which race. And so let's just dive right in and talk a little bit about how Orc Racials changed. So the big one here, in my opinion, is axe specialization. This now also applies to fist weapons too, so that's a bit of a change. But even a bigger change is Blood Fury. If you see here, the TBC Blood Fury reduced, and of course vanilla, reduced healing effects on you by 50%. Now in Wrath of the Lich King, that is entirely gone. So Blood Fury has lost the downside, and now it's all just upside. So Blood Fury, a major buff to Blood Fury. You can pop it all the time without worrying about that healing debuff. Hardiness is exactly the same as it used to be. And then Command actually now applies to all pets. So if you are a Death Knight, your Ghoul, your Army of the Dead, any pets for any class, orcs get that 5% increased damage dealt. Let's move on to Undead. Will of the Forsaken got kind of a big nerf in Wrath of the Lich King. It now only removes Fear, Charm, and Sleep. It does not grant that immunity for 5 seconds as well, and it now will share a 45-second cooldown with similar effects, aka PvP trinket. So this is a pretty sizable nerf. If you're, you know, for PvP, I would say in PvE, it's still nice because you typically don't have a PvP trinket on in PvE situations, which is why it's still a great racial, but it is nerfed quite heavily for PvP. Cannibalize is unchanged. If we go over to Shadow Resistance, we actually see it now reduces the chance you will be hit by shadow spells by 2% instead of granting 10 resistance. Now you might be wondering, is this a buff or a nerf? Well, resistance is calculated in both a binary and non-binary way in World of Warcraft. Binary meaning sort of 0 or 1. Does the spell hit and do damage, or does it not hit and do no damage, right? It's binary. The second calculation, the non-binary calculation in TBC, did, you know, does the spell do 25% reduced damage, 50%, or 75% reduced damage? Now, in Wrath of the Lich King, it's increments of 10, so 10, 20, 30, 40, so on, instead of increments of 25%. So actually, I would say this is a buff, because now in Wrath of the Lich King, you can still max out your resistances, but you now have a racial that helps with that binary portion of the resistance calculation. That is, does the spell hit or not? So I consider this a buff, quite a nice buff indeed. And this applies to many other racials that we're going to go through. Underwater breathing was nerfed slightly. This is not too big of a deal. It's still a nice increase over other races. Okay, let's move on to Tauren. Tauren, kind of same overall. War Stomp is exactly the same. Cultivation is exactly the same. Endurance, though, has actually taken a nerf, believe it or not. It has now changed to base health instead of total health, increased by 5%. So this is overall a nerf, which is unfortunate. This was, I think, a really good Tauren racial, but it is getting nerfed in Wrath of the Lich King. Nature Resistance, like Shadow Resistance for Undead, will now reduce the chance you get hit by nature spells by 2%. Again, I think this is a buff, and if you skip to Tauren, go look at the Undead section where I give you the long version of that answer. Okay, let's move on to Troll. So Troll Regeneration is the same, Beast Slaying is the same, but Berserking has gotten a buff, in my opinion. It will always give you a 20% increased attack and casting speed, rather than a range between 10 and 30% based on how low health you are. Now, I consider this a buff because in PvE, DPS typically aren't getting to low health enough to get a big bonus off of this, and it could potentially be a nerf, though, as well for pro gamers who are just amazing at using this at the right time and plan for it and know how to get to that health and then use it. Tanks, maybe, or, you know, other players. So in a way, it's a buff and a nerf, but I would say a buff overall. Bow and throwing specializations are both exactly the same, but a new passive was added in Wrath of the Lich King there at the bottom called Da Voodoo Shuffle. This reduces the duration of all movement impairing effects by 15%. It's insane. It's amazing. This is incredible. I really think this puts Troll on par for Orcs for being like one of the best races on the Horde. It's very, very good for PvP, even in PvE scenarios too. Okay, let's talk about Blood Elves. Well, the big one here is that mana tap is gone, deleted, removed from the game. I would say this is a nerf because you could steal mana with it, which was kind of cool. It was also used as an extra buff on your buff bar to protect your other buffs from being dispelled in a PvP scenario. If remember, you get charges. Arcane Torrent now gives back a percentage of mana, which is very nice, actually. I'd consider that a buff. And it still does its AoE silence and the same for the most part, but since now it scales, I would say this is a buff. Of course, it gives you other resources depending on your class, not just mana, so energy, runic power, etc. Arcane Affinity is exactly the same, giving that enchanting skill. And Magic Resistance is buffed, which is amazing. Gives you that 2% reduced chance to be hit by spells, same as that Nature and Shadow Resist for Tauren and Undead, respectively. This is huge. Again, I think this is a nice buff. But anyways, changing gears, we're going to talk about what is the best race for each class. And first up, we're going to talk about the Warrior. So the Warrior in Wrath of the Lich King could be quite a good class, but we're going to focus on which race is the best. I think Orc and Troll are tied. They both have incredible, incredible racials. Dovudu Shuffle, I think, really helps both in PvE and PvP. Axe specialization, hardiness, the fact that Blood Fury is no longer having that that healing debuff, all very, very good racials. I felt like Undead doesn't really help anything that help. They don't have anything that really helps their damage very much, but I do want to acknowledge Will of the Forsaken, so I do rank them a bit higher than Tauren, who really don't have anything. The reason I think Will of the Forsaken can help your damage is if you get feared or something, you can pop it and get back to doing damage. Looking at PvP, it's a different story. I think that Orc are still like dominant. I think hardiness is super OP still. Axe specialization, the fact that Blood Fury can now be used all the time is very, very powerful. Will the Forsaken, I still think, is strong in PvP. Cannibalize is strong. Tauren War Stomp is very strong as well. Endurance is still good. And then Troll Davudu Shuffle, I think, really helps a lot, along with Berserking. Very, very nice buffs. I think Beast Slaying can be situationally helpful. Troll Regeneration, I don't want to, or just Regeneration, I don't want to skip over that. That's also very helpful. Well, not very, but it's it helps. Talking about Tank now, we can start with Troll. I think pretty much everything I just said about Trolls applies much more for a Tank. That Berserking helps you get extra threat. It can, the regeneration, you're the tank, it's going to help a lot. It's going to get more value. Davudu Shuffle can help. Beast Slaying can help. Pretty much everything can help. So Troll has a ton of racials that are beneficial for being a tank. Tauren have that endurance, even though it's not as good. I still think it's helpful. But I would say, Orc with that Axe specialization, 5 expertise, it's helpful. Blood Fury can now be used by tanks and without fear, so that's definitely a big buff. I guess hardiness could be helpful in situations where you're up against PvE mobs that stun you. That you don't want to be a tank who's stunned, right? And then Undead, don't have too much, but Will the Forsaken helps a bit once again. All right, let's look at Rogue. So every class can be Rogue except for Tauren here. When it comes to PvE, I think Orc takes number one now in Wrath of the Lich King. Rogues can finally use axes. I believe it was patch 3.0.2 where Blizzard says after much quiet contemplation, Rogues can now use axes, one-handed axes. So yes, it happened in Wrath of the Lich King. I think this might be what tips Orc to being the best rogue, perhaps. Having that extra expertise, 5 extra expertise. You can use Blood Fury again. Some nice stuff for rogues there. When it comes to Undead, they don't actually have really anything again. Only Will of the Forsaken. Troll have a lot of good stuff too, so they're up there. Blood Elf does not really have much, but Arcane Tauren can definitely be helpful for getting some extra energy boost, so wouldn't discount them entirely, and I would place them above Undead. When it comes to PvP, I think Undead Rogue still dominates. I mean, just for the longest time, they've just been the bane of all spellcasters. You know, it's just so hard to peel. I think they're incredible. Orc, very, very close second, I would say. And quite frankly, I mean, interchangeably, you know, depending on your playstyle, what class you're up against, you know, Orc could be the best PvP DPS as well, or even Troll. They're all pretty close. I would say Blood Elf is very strong, though, too. You can't discount Arcane Torrent being an AoE silence. That can be incredibly powerful as going up against spellcasters. So almost all the races, I would say, are incredible in PvP. I would say Troll's probably the weakest. Out of all of this, they don't really have an activatable ability besides berserking. But it's all pretty close. All races are pretty good. I thought Blizzard did a good job balancing in Wrath of the Lich King. When it comes to mages, Tauren and Orcs cannot be mages, but the other Horde classes can. For PvE DPS, I think Troll just takes the cake here. They've got Berserking, that 20% increased cast speed. I think that's just huge, and the other races don't have anything to really come close to that. Next best would be Blood Elf with that Arcane Torrent for more mana. Again, it scales with mana, so that makes it good. Makes it more powerful. When it comes to PvP, it's definitely close. Very close race, but I think Undead, Will of the Forsaken is really good. Berserking is very, very strong, though, so very close second in my opinion. Devoodoo Shuffle is a great PvP racial, in my opinion. And then, of course, the Blood Elves come in third. They're decent. You know, if you get in melee range with someone and use that Arcane Torrent, could be a nice extra silence. Okay, let's move on to Warlock. Orc, Undead, and Blood Elf. So I would say Orc is probably number one for PvE DPS. The Blood Fury, increasing spell power, just straight up helps. And also, if you have a pet, Command is going to be helpful. It's going to give you 5% increased damage of your pet. So Demonology Warlock, for example, even Affliction, you're going to have a pet out. So I would say Orc is pretty much number one. Number two, could probably be Blood Elf, honestly. It's pretty close between Undead and Blood Elf. Again, Will of the Forsaken, I'm just putting a lot of credit towards it to get out of fear. But Arcane Torrent is pretty nice to get that extra mana back as a Warlock, but not really needed. So that's probably why I put Undead above Blood Elf, because you have Life Tap as a Warlock. Moving on to PvP DPS, pretty much tie between Orc and Undead. They've always been really, really good, both of them. It's just a matter of, do you want hardiness and command and Blood Fury versus do you want like Will of the Forsaken? And Will of the Forsaken is kind of nerfed, so maybe Orc is better in Wrath of the Lich King. And then, of course, Blood Elf, Arcane Torrent, just extra mana, but also an interrupt. But I would say probably Orc. I'd say Orc probably takes it for PvP in Wrath of the Lich King just because of the Blood Fury buff. All right, let's move on to the Hunter. Anyone but the Undead can be Hunters. So for PvE DPS, I think Troll takes it. Troll, once again, Berserking. They got the bow, specialization, which is awesome. You know, Beast Slaying, Berserking being the biggest one. And then for Orc, you've just got Command, which is helpful to make your pet do more damage. And Blood Fury, so it's kind of like Troll have three racials that help, Orc have two, Tauren really have zero that help do more damage, and then Blood Elf, it's just a little bit about getting some mana back with Arcane Torrent. So I'd go Troll if I was a Hunter for PvE. For PvP, I think Orc is going to be your best bet. The buff to Blood Fury, you've got Command, Hardiness, Axe Specialization. Doesn't help that much, but helps a little bit if you're using axes, right? But overall, pretty much every racial helps Orc Hunters in PvP. Tauren Hunters, not to be discounted. War Stomp is quite nice. Endurance is decent. And Troll, Devoodoo Shuffle, very, very good in PvP. Berserking's even better now. Troll Regeneration, Bow Specialization. It's pretty close. It's close between most of the classes. I think Orc takes it, though. Blood Elf, again, with that AoE silence. Moving on to Shaman. Any class can be a Shaman besides Blood Elves and Undead for Horde. So Orc, Tauren, Troll. You can probably see a common theme here. I think that Orc and Troll are pretty amazing for the Horde. In many cases, for PvE DPS, Tauren just don't have anything, so that's why I kind of rated them lower, whereas Troll and Orc have some stuff to offer. Well, really, I would say Troll probably is, it depends, right, if you're Enhance or Elemental. Like, if you're Enhance, probably go Orc. If you're Elemental, it looks like Troll would probably be better, right? Axe Specialization. I mean, I don't know, Berserking is could be good enough to go enhance for troll too. For PvE healer, definitely go troll. I think they win that battle with berserking. And then in second, like Orc, the Blood Fury will help increase your healing in Wrath of the Lich King. For PvP, it's very, very close, once again, between Orc and Troll, in my opinion. For the same reasons I've been saying throughout, like Berserking, Troll Regeneration, Davudu Shuffle versus Hardiness, Blood Fury, Axe Specialization, all those things. When it comes to PvP healing, pretty much same deal. Pretty much everything still counts. I would say War Stomp's a great escape, so I don't want to discount that. But for the most part, Racials are strong for the same reasons if you're a healer, except, I mean, the fact that Blood Fury is so flexible makes it pretty much the same. And now Priests. This is a really big one. The crazy thing about Priests is that their Racials are really reworked in Wrath of the Lich King. There's actually no more Racials. You can see I just put a giant X here. What's going away, you might be wondering. Well, Star Shards. I know, I can see your tears. It got good in TBC. So Star Shards, the history of it is kind of interesting. I actually made a Night Elf Priest in Vanilla because I wanted it to work. But really, they're not that great. In TBC, they got great. It became a dot, an extra dot, which was great. But now in Wrath of the Lich King, they're being removed, along with Elune's Grace, which was actually a pretty nice Night Elf racial as well. Reduces the chance they'll get hit by melee and ranged attacks by 20%, which is pretty nice, like a weak evasion. Touch of Weakness, which was a personal favorite of mine. I also leveled an Undead Priest. Man, I played way too many priests. Anytime someone hits you, they do reduced melee damage and take some shadow damage. Blood Elves had Touch of Weakness too. And then Consume Magic is gone. That I won't miss. Was not really strong. Hex of Weakness was actually pretty good. This was like an MS effect. Reduces healing by 20%. Trolls were pretty good in PvP. I think they were underrated. Shadow Guard, again, another troll one. This could proc like Blackout. So another really good troll priest racial gone. I could also talk about the Alliance ones. This is a Horde video, but Chastise and Feedback are also gone. But we're going to keep it to the Horde for now. There's three priest racials that are now becoming accessible to everyone, and those are Desperate Prayer. This is now an 11-point talent in the Holy Tree. Holy Nova is now going to be a base ability in Wrath of the Lich King, and the Desperate Prayer cooldown has been reduced to 30 seconds. Also, Devouring Plague is now a base ability. The cooldown is reduced to 30 seconds, and the mana cost was greatly reduced. I don't know about you, but I would usually use like Inner Fire Devouring Plague because it costs so much mana. So I'm really glad they reduced the mana cost. Symbol of Hope is also now a base ability. If you remember, this was a Drenai priest racial. It restores in Wrath of the Lich King 5% base mana every 2 seconds for 8 seconds to your party. It's actually renamed to Hymn of Hope. So no longer is it called Symbol of Hope. It's going to be called Hymn of Hope. Base ability for priests. So priest racials, totally gone. And some of them became base or found in the talent tree. Now, you might be wondering then, what is the best race for priests with all these changes? Well, to be honest, I think with the removal of so many priest racials, that decision becomes a lot easier and not as big of a deal, which is kind of crazy because that was sort of the main priest flavor, if you ask me, choosing your race. But unfortunately, I didn't like how in vanilla you had to be a dwarf priest, really. So I would say it matters less, but I'm still going to give you my opinion on what I think is best. And I think troll is best for PvE DPS because of how good berserking is. You know, short and sweet. That's why I think troll is the best for PvE DPS. When it comes to PvE healer, pretty much same reason. I think berserking is incredible. I mean, arcane tap is okay, right? Getting that extra mana. Undead don't really have much for PvE healing. I guess Will of the Forsaken's okay. When it comes to PvP DPS, you know, I would say you can go either way. Like Will of the Forsaken's are such a good PvP talent, so it's really good. But at the same time, trolls have like Davudu Shuffle to like not have snares work as well on them. Berserking's also still great, and troll regeneration. So it's kind of matched. I think Will of the Forsaken's still a great talent, and then Blood Elves have Arcane Torrent, which could be good because if you're a priest, you're gonna try to get close to your enemies to use Psychic Scream anyways. So Blood Elf's not bad. Same with PvP healer. I would say it's pretty much exactly the same ratings. Really, troll or undead I think are the best, but Blood Elf not terrible. Let's move on to the Death Knight. The Death Knight is the new hero class coming in Wrath of the Lich King. Any Horde race can play them. Orc, Undead, Tauren, Troll, and Blood Elf, which is why this decision is probably the hardest out of all the classes that we've gone through, because you have so many options and it can be paralyzing to decide which one is truly the best. Well, let's talk about PvP DPS. And you can see some similarities. Now, I rated both Orc and Troll as top picks for PvP DPS. So if you're running like an unholy, if you want to run like an unholy Death Knight, this is a really good pick. I'd say the reasons why Orc is a really good pick for an undead Death Knight is because of command and unholy Death Knights. They have their pet out all the time, so command is going to get a lot of value there. Blood Fury is very nice. It's going to give you that melee attack power. And then, of course, Axe Specialization is going to be very helpful, aiming for Shadowmourne in endgame. So pretty much you can get value out of almost all your racials. Hardiness is just like icing on the top. But Orc pretty much benefit across the board, especially if you're going to be a PvP DPS, especially an unholy Orc Death Knight. So that's a pretty solid choice. I would say very close is Troll, because Berserking is very strong. Devoodoo Shuffle, doesn't really... Or this is PvP DPS. So yeah, helps in PvP for sure. Hardiness absolutely helps in PvP. So Beast Lane could be helpful as well. I would say probably, yeah, it's very close between the two, but I would say maybe Orc is slightly better in my opinion. And then I would say Undead is the next pick for Will of the Forsaken. Tauren have War Stomp, so I'd kind of put Tauren and Blood Elf kind of equal. Maybe Tauren slightly better than Blood Elf, because Arcane Torrent is only for works on spellcasters, but if you can pull off a War Stomp, that's going to work on any class and take them out of the fight for a few seconds. So kind of even, but maybe Tauren slightly better than Blood Elves. So I would say Orc number one. I just think Hardiness is better than Devoodoo Shuffle slightly. For PvE, very similar. You can see not much changed other than I kind of gave Tauren and Blood Elf even less points. Orc, for all the reasons I talked about before. Tauren and Blood Elves, their racials aren't as good for PvE, especially Tauren. Arcane Tauren has some use though. All right, when it comes to tanking, the Blood Death Knight tank. So Orc, I would actually say, is not very good. You can see they lost a bunch of rating here with me. And I actually put, I still have a lot of faith in Troll. So if you want to be a Blood Death Knight tank, I think Troll's the way to go. Berserking for that extra threat generation. It's got that Troll regeneration is going to be helpful. It's pretty good. Pretty good stuff there for Troll. Blood Elf, pretty decent. You get Arcane Torrent for that AoE silence. And I would also say it's pretty good for Tauren as well. War Stomp's a little harder to use as a tank, so mainly Endurance is why I put Tauren up there. Even though it was nerfed, it's still nice to get that extra health. And then Undead is like Will of the Forsaken to help with crowd control, and then I put kind of Orc as last. Really the only thing that helps probably Axe Specialization. I guess Command can help while you have your Ghoul out temporarily. I guess Blood Fury is good too. So it's a close fight but for some of these races, but I'd say Troll's probably the best tank for a Blood Death Knight. And we're at the Paladin here, and the only race that can be Paladin is Blood Elves, so not much to say here, just choose your Paladin. And then Druids can only be Tauren, so choose your Tauren. And that's pretty much it, guys. Hope you like this video. Racials changed a lot in Wrath of the Lich King, so hopefully now you're up to date on all of that. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. And if you enjoyed this guide, more are coming like this, so subscribe so you don't miss out. My name is Toyhouze. I hope you have a great day, and I will see you in the next video. Take care.